Hello everyone, welcome to Insecta channel. Today we will start stored grain pests and their management. First we will see the definition. So storage pest, it is an insect or other animal, suppose rat also causing damage to the stored product, then also it will come under the storage pest. So what is storage pest? So storage pest is an insect or other animal that damages or destroys the stored food or other stored valuable organic matter. So they are known as store insect pest. So insects are a large proportion of a storage pest with which each type of crop having specific insect and gravitate towards them. For example, see, for the if you are storing pulses, so pulse beetle will attack, then Triballium species will attack, then if you are storing rice, then rice weevil will attack. So for the specific product, specific pests are also there. And among the in storage pests, most of the pests are belongs to insect. Next we'll see why there is a need to study about this storage insect. Because in India, post-harvest losses caused by unscientific storage, then insects, then rodents, then microorganism, etc. So why the post-harvest loss is occurring? Because wherever we are storing the product, so that is the farmers or many people, they are storing in an unscientific way. And also the insect is attacking, rodents are attacking, and due to the contamination of microorganisms also post-harvest loss is occurring. So about 10% of the total food grain is lost by the post-harvest losses. Next, so if the insects or pests are attacking to this stored grain, then they are making the stored food unfit for the human consumption. Next, make seed unfit for planting also. Suppose this is one rice seed or paddy, suppose this is the paddy or the whole grain pulses, and insect are eating the cotyledon or the embryo, then what will happen? If they are making this seed unfit for the planting material. Next we'll see the classification of stored grain insect pest. So they are classified into primary storage pest and secondary storage pest. So first we'll see the primary stored grain pest. The definition is, these are cause damage to the stored grain directly by feeding on the grain at some point in their life cycle. Suppose they are feeding in larval stages or the adult stages, but they are causing damage by directly feeding on the grain. They are known as primary stored grain. So again, this primary stored grain, there are two types. One is internal feeder, another one is external feeder. So what is the meaning of internal feeder? The name itself indicating that they will feed within the kernel. So they will stay inside the kernel and they will feed the kernel. They will stay inside the seed. Then external feeder means they will only feed on the surface of the seed. So what are the example? Rice weevil, lesser grain borer, anguismus moth, pulse beetle, cigarette beetle. Then red floor beetle is the external feeder, Indian meal moth, rice moth, khapra beetle, almond moth. These are the example of external feeder. Next we'll see secondary stored grain pest. So already we know what is primary, that means they will cause direct damage by feeding on it. Then secondary means these are able to attack only the material that have been previously damaged, either by other pest or by poor threshing, drying or handling. So secondary stored grain kya hai? Ye jo insect hote hai ya phir pest hote hai, ye usi product ko khate hai jo ki pehle se damage hai. Suppose ye ek pulse hai, तो ये ऑलरेडी डैमेज हुआ है, उसी को ही जो फीड करते हैं जो इंसेक्ट, उसको बोलते हैं सेकेंडरी स्टोर्ड ग्रेन पेस्ट. सो ऑलरेडी डैमेज किया गया है. कैसे डैमेज हुआ? आइदर इन पुअर थ्रेशिंग और ड्यूरिंग द ड्राइंग और ड्यूरिंग हैंडलिंग टाइम, उसी में भी अगर ये डैमेज होता है तो भी जो पेस्ट उनको खाते हैं उनको सेकेंडरी स्टोर्ड ग्रेन कहते हैं. या फिर प्राइमरी इंसेक्ट, एक सपोज दिस इज़ वन ग्रेन एंड प्राइमरी इंसेक्ट इज़ अटैकिंग टू दैट ग्रेन एंड दे मेक होल एंड दे वेंट आउट, देन दिस इज़ ऑलरेडी डैमेज. अगेन अनदर पेस्ट इज कमिंग एंड अटैकिंग दिस, सो दैट पेस्ट बिकमिंग द सेकेंडरी पेस्ट. So what are the example? Sawtooth grain beetle, long headed floor beetle, flat grain beetle are the example. Next, we'll see the factors affecting the losses of stored grain. So what are the factors? There are four factors. One is physical, then biological, chemical and mechanical. So under this physical factor, light, temperature, moisture will come. So these are the reason why there is a loss of stored grain. Then biological means insect pest will come, that we'll discuss here. Then microorganisms, mites, rodents, birds will come. Then chemical means due to oxygen, carbon dioxide level also, percentage of oxygen and carbon dioxide also responsible for the loss occurred in the stored grain. Then mechanical, during packaging or the storage structure also leads to the loss of stored grain. So these we'll discuss one by one. So now we'll discuss the physical factor, that is light. So the black carpet beetle, they are mostly, they will attracted to the strong sunlight, whereas the larva of this beetle, they will attracted towards the dark. So the larva and adult, they prefer different light during their growth. Then suppose you are storing wheat in a gunny bag and you are keeping it in shade, then more insect will attract to this gunny bag. But if you are keeping this same gunny bag to the light, to the sunlight, then insect will not attract much. Next we'll see the temperature. So how the temperature is affecting? So normally the insect, they require the temperature that is 28 to 38 degrees Celsius, and also they can develop up to 42 degrees Celsius, but not all insect can develop in this temperature. Mostly the insect will die above the 42 degrees Celsius temperature. Then if the temperature goes down, suppose 15 degrees Celsius, below 15 degrees means the insect will stop grow. The growth of the insect or the development of the insect will stop below 15 degrees Celsius temperature, and below 10 degrees Celsius means the insect will die. Next we'll see moisture. The range of moisture at the time of storage should be between 11.8 to 17% for the summer and 10 to 17% during the winter crops.